Hello friends, welcome to my channel, myself Parag Jambulkar. In this video, we'll discuss about socket programming. Assume this is the network we have and these are the nodes. These nodes can be computer or this can be any electronic device, for example our mobile phones or PDE. Suppose this is sender and this is the receiver. All these nodes are connected with each other by some communication medium. So when we are sending any message from sender to receiver, so definitely it will not go directly from sender to receiver. It has to follow the medium. So suppose that message is going to this node, and then it is going to this node. So it is following this network path. So in between there are some routing protocols. So by using this routing protocols, that message is passed to receiver. In network, all these nodes have a special identity and that is called as IP address. So all nodes, they have their IP address. So in the same way, this receiver has IP address. So while sending that message from sender to the receiver, we have to mention the IP address to whom you want to send message. Now, and again some routing protocols will be there. So following these routing protocols, this routing protocol mention where that IP address, node with that IP address is located. On this node, many applications are running. For example, Firefox, any web browser, or suppose an application installed over there just like Skype or any other application. So out of those applications, to which application you want to send the message, it is given by or it is mentioned by port number. So every application has a separate port number. So when you are sending message from sender to receiver, two things you require. One is the address of this node, so that your message will go from this node to this node only. When message has come to this node, there are several applications are running. So out of those several applications, to which application that message should be delivered, it is mentioned by the port number. So when we combine this both IP address and port number, so combinedly it is called as socket. Here port number is of 16 bit. Just like IP address can be of 32 bit or 128 bit, port number is of 16 bit. So suppose if you want to define socket, then socket is an endpoint which is used for sending or receiving, and it is a combination of IP address and port number. When message is sent from sender to receiver, some operations are performed over this message. For example, encryption, compression, like this. If you combine similar operations together, we got OSI model layers. So basically, these are the some similar operations. If you combine together, then we got application layer. Again, some similar operations combined together, it becomes presentation layer. Similar operations combined together become session layer. So when this message is sent from sender to receiver, some operations are performed over that message, and on receiver side again these operations are done, but on reverse side, on reverse way. So these similar operations combined together become OSI model layer. For example, application layer directly deal with the application. So any application that is running on the sender, for example your web browser, so application layer directly deal with the application that is on sender, that application will send the message. Presentation layer is for encryption or compression. Session layer is to maintain a session for the continuous transmission of the message. Transport layer is about transporting the data segments on the other side, while network layer is for managing the network. Data link layer is for sending the data frames and also error recovery and flow control, while physical layer is the functions which is directly linked with the communication medium. So from this socket, that IP address is linked with network layer, while port number is linked with transport layer. So we have defined socket as an endpoint which is used for sending and receiving the messages, and it is a combination of IP address and port number. IP address can be of 32 bit. If you are using IP version 4 addressing, it can be 128 bits. If you are using IP version 6 addressing. Nowadays we are using 32 bit addressing, but afterwards in future 128 bit addressing will be used. When it is a IP version 4, that is a 32 bit IP addresses, so it has 4 octets. So 1 octet of 8 bits, then 8 bits, 8 bits and 8 bits, it is an octet. And each octet is of 8 bits and is separated by dot. While in IP version 6, when address is 128 bit, it is shown like this. So each this part is called as a quartet. Quartet means of 16 bits. And there are 8 quartets. And all these quartets are separated by colon. Port number is of size 16 bits. And the port numbers that we get are the unsigned integers. That's why possible number of port numbers are from 0 to 65,535. These port numbers are classified like this. So there are three categories of port numbers. Port numbers from 0 to 1023 are called as well-known ports. Well-known ports in the sense, these port numbers are reserved for special service. For example, for FTP, port number 20 and 21 is reserved. For Telnet, port number 23 is reserved. For HTTP, port number 80 is reserved. So this port number you cannot use for your application. Port numbers from 1024 to 49,151 can be registered by private companies. So that's why it is called a registered port. Private companies can approach to IANA, that is the organization which registers these port numbers. For example, MySQL, that port number for MySQL is registered, and that port number for MySQL is 3306. Third category is this. Port number from 49,152 to 65,535 cannot be registered by any private company. These are the free ports, are also called as dynamic or private ports, and you can use for your application. Even port numbers from this category we can use for our private application. There are various functions or APIs which work on socket. These are called as socket primitive. For example, socket, bind, connect, send, receive, close, listen, accept, etc. Socket, that function is used for creating a socket. Bind function is for binding IP address with the port number. So socket and bind on both sides, client and server. On server side, there is a function called a listen, which takes server to the listen mode. So it keep listening for request from client side. Then on client side, there is a function called as connect, which send request to server for connection. When request from client is sent to the server, on server side there is a function which get executed called as accept. So server accept the request from the client. After that, once connection is established, messages are sent from client to server and from server to client like this. And at the end, the connection is closed. Here, manually we are establishing connection between client and server. That's why it is called as connection oriented services. For example, TCP protocol, that is transmission control protocol, use connection oriented services. If we remove this connect, listen and accept, it becomes connectionless services. For example, here you can see socket for creating the socket, bind for binding IP address with the port number. So there is no listen, connect and accept. Directly you can send the message and we can receive the message, and after that socket is closed. This is called a connectionless services. For example, protocol UDP. UDP is also called a user datagram protocol. So UDP uses connectionless services. Based on where these sockets are used, there are various types of sockets. For example, sockets which are used in connection oriented services, for example TCP, are called as stream sockets. Sockets which are used in connectionless services, for example UDP, are called as datagram sockets. While sockets which are used at routers are called as raw sockets. So at router, there is no need of port numbers. Only IP addresses are required. So such sockets are called as raw sockets. Fourth type is sequence packet sockets. These sockets are just like stream sockets. Only difference is they also maintain one more information, that is a boundary between the packets or records, so that these packets can be sequenced. That's why it is called as sequence packet sockets. So friends, I hope you like this video. If yes, then click on like, subscribe to the channel and don't forget to press bell icon so that you will get notifications of my next video. So stay connected. Thank you.